Hey folks, Doug from blowback9.com here. Wanted to go over a few updates regarding 9mm AR bolts. I did a video recently about the specific bolt I would choose and why. Also did a video on the Mercury Precision bolt, the $54 bolt. And I've got a couple updates that I wanted to let you know about. First of all, regarding the Mercury Precision bolt, I decided to try a mil-spec extractor as well as the appropriate hardware inside, which would be a spring, rubber post, and O-ring. Installed that into the Mercury Precision bolt, and it worked great. There was one weird hiccup. Oop, that was interesting. Looks like something didn't want to feed quite right. Had a little hesitation there. Have to keep an eye on that. Oh, we are empty. Let's try next mag. And that may have just been some sort of a weird issue with this one round with breaking in that new extractor. Fired the round just fine. And I don't know what exactly caused that, but it was like a hesitation as it went to feed. But after that, it ran fine, and I didn't run a lot of rounds through it. I just didn't have time. I did use it in various uppers as I was doing some experimentation. So I probably put a little over 100 rounds through it, and it seemed to work great. So no problem with putting, at least with mine, no problem with putting a mil-spec extractor and associated hardware into it. Now, I did see someone had reported that they tried putting the mil-spec spring, post, and O-ring into the standard extractor that comes with the Mercury Precision bolt, and that did not work. I believe they said they put the post in and it did function, but when they put the O-ring in, it did not. So I think the Mercury Precision standard extractor that comes with it is best used as is, and in my case, it ran fine. It really didn't seem to need that mil-spec extractor and hardware, but it will accept them and it will run with the mil-spec stuff, so no problem there. Second update, the Taccom bolt. I had mentioned in my bolt video that I had problems with it locking back. It must have something to do with my spikes lower. Don't know what's going on there. It does have a Law Tactical folder on the spikes lower, and that may be what's causing the problem. But when I ran the Taccom short stroke bolt in an FM-9 lower, it ran fine. So it locked back in both the full stroke and short stroke configurations. So Taccom short stroke bolt worked great with the FM-9 lower. Last thing was the FM-9 bolt. I had mentioned that there were some issues with it regarding potential slam fires. Some folks had mentioned it was denting primers, and that was likely due to a combination of FM recommending a 308 spring, which I still say is not a good idea at all. 9mm does not need, require, or benefit from a 308 recoil spring. And a combination of that recoil spring and the very light firing pin spring that they have in the bolt. And one of my colleagues on Reddit has discovered that Amazon has, through another vendor, are selling a spring which can be a drop-in replacement for the firing pin spring for the FM-9 bolt, and it brings the spring tension up to about the same as the rest of the bolts out there that are typical, maybe about, I think it was about 26 ounces of pressure to push the firing pin to a fully extended position. So I'll put a link either in the description, which may or may not be live, and I'll put it in a comment for that set of springs. It's just one spring. I believe it's a 5mm spring, and it ran great with that spring in the firing pin channel and didn't show any signs of denting primers or anything like that. Of course, I don't use 308 recoil springs either, but ran good with that. So that's what I have for my updates for the bolts. Hope this video finds you well, and that's all I've got for now. So take care, and I'll see you in the next video.